Alright folks, welcome back. We're jumping into the Driving Academy again. I said I was going to continue to keep doing this. We're going to finish up Chapter 3. And yeah, we're going to keep doing this. And then maybe go take a couple jobs. Jug handle and button hook turns. Ahead of you, there are some tight turns with little room to spare. These will help you learn to maneuver the trailer efficiently. Effectively. First turn requires a jug handle maneuver. This turn applies to turns where you have to, where you have limited room on a road you're turning into and must utilize extra space on the road. Follow the lane markings to swing the tractor far and wide from the inside curb. I don't know how you guys spell curb over there, but in America, it's C-U-R-B. This will bring your trailer away from the curb so that you have sufficient room to maneuver. Keep close to the obstacle as you exit so the trailer continues to follow the widest arch possible. As you enter the long curve, you must keep the tractor towards the center of the road to keep trailer wheels off the curb. Continue along the road. The next turn requires the use of a button hook maneuver. This is the preferred technique as it doesn't always open up the lane behind you for an attentive motorist to sneak up on the right side. Always use it when you have enough space on the road. Drive deep into the intersection and quickly make a sharp turn to the right. As you come alongside the obstacle, you can straighten it out and again keep towards the left side of your lane. All of this serves to keep the trailer wheels away from the curb. Continue towards the next curve. Once again, keep towards the middle of the road to keep the trailer wheels away from the curb. Corner ahead is especially troublesome. In cases like this, you will not have ideal conditions for either a jug handle or a button hook and must combine both maneuvers to get where you need. Swing wide before the turn, drive deep into the intersection, and quickly turn in. Once again, it's ideal to stay as close as possible to the obstacle to keep the turn wide as possible. Park in the designated area, secure the truck, and shut down the engine. Alright, pretty standard. Let me jump off for a minute. Okay. I wasn't off the curve, but you know what? No collisions. Fuck. Restart. We already know. That was my bad, because I was going a little too fast. I don't even know what the fuck I hit. Fucking cones, are you kidding me? God damn it. What the hell? The fucking cone's on the curb. I give up. I fucking quit. I don't know what the hell I hit. I was good going through that. That's where it said I had a collision. I don't know. I try it one more time. Well, that one is because that I will. That was my fuck up. It hit the fucking curb, I just seen it. God damn it, that is not fucking easy to do. And what's fucking me up is I don't use them damn mirrors on the truck. In the front. Hit the fucking curb. How the fuck do you keep hitting the damn curb? Of course, because I went too fucking far in, trying to make sure not to hit the fucking curb. Because of the fucking cones! Jesus Christ! Limited room my ass. When you've got a fucking turn like that, you do take the curb. I don't care what they say. You know, if you'd like to know where the fuck they learn this. Of course, because you gotta have fucking cones right there. I'm sorry. No driver. I'm not using turn signals. Maybe that's what's distracting me. Finally. All right. Right there. All right. Because I hit the front. Okay. That's 30 minutes of me doing this. Damn it! I took that. You know what? I'm calling it quits right here, folks.